what you want. And I we're so back.
Let's get straight to it. I don't really care about small talk today. I've been thinking a lot about how busy we all are and how a lot of our days are just full of task, 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 another task, a meeting, a hangout with a friend, constant talking, going to bed late, waking up, task, task, workout. Like, I'm constantly busy from the beginning of the day to the end of the day. And in terms of free time to just sit in my own self-misery, to sit and let myself like think about things, process things, relax, I don't have that much time. This has been like really true as of recently. And so I took some time this week to like really, really force myself to slow down. And in this video, you're gonna come with me and see how I did that. But before we get to it, let me explain why it's important. I think that I and a lot of people have this constant mental chatter, right? And it's like, a lot of it is really unproductive. I read this book, actually, where is it? Have you guys read, this is a really popular book, but have you ever read The Power of Now? Or the subsequent sequel, A New Earth? Or an also relevant book kind of related to mindfulness, Waking Up, A Guide to Spirituality Without Religion. Anyways, I've read all these books, along with this book, Stillness is the Key by Ryan Holiday. I don't think I have a copy of it in my apartment anymore, but long story short, there's this idea of like when we are able to be still and slow down, we can kind of get a grip on that like endless mental chatter that goes on, a lot of which is really unproductive mental chatter, like ruminating, working through situations that will never happen, or working through situations that have already happened and you can't undo, or like destructive self-doubt, or maybe it's overthinking, maybe it's just anxious thoughts in general. It can kind of feel like they control us. And if you're anything like me, you'll fill your day and any free time you either book something to do or you scroll on your phone so that you never really have to sit down and listen to the voices in your head. The voices. Yeah. And when we think about creativity and wanting to be able to make things, to be receptive to new ideas, like even with making this YouTube video, like there's some kind of act of creating with this, and along with like all of my short form content on Instagram and TikTok, a little bit. But when we think about that, we need to have like enough mental clarity to be able to receive the good ideas. Like if you're always busy and you're always constantly thinking yourself into the ground, it's like there's a million voices in your head and you never can like hear, ooh, what about this idea? Much less have the time and space and energy to like see the idea through or pursue it or like make it come to life, right? So that's what I've been thinking about. And there's like really practical, easy ways to just kind of like quiet the noise, box that shit down, and be present. I know, and I'm sitting here on my woo-woo self-help spiritual guru shit, but it's really not that deep. I feel like, I don't know why other people don't think about these things more often. And even if you aren't a person that like, you're not a content creator, you're not an artist, you're not a writer, like you don't produce stuff like that, like you don't make things. Just in general, having like quieter mental state and like a more focused mental clarity that is like less full of distractions, cheap dopamine, constant doom scrolling, constant rumination, like that is healthy in terms of well-being in general. So maybe everybody can glean something from this today. But, and cringe warning, my advice and my thoughts for today and the things I put into practice the last few weeks have all led me to you today to tell you, relax, shut up, slow down. It's really not that deep. Life is long. These little anxieties throughout your day, they feel like everything, and we can get where we're so deep head down in our own bullshit that you never zoom out and see the bigger perspective of like, look at me, I'm just one person on this giant earth that's been around for millions of years and will be around for thousands more. I don't know exactly if it's thousands, million, like the math is personally like not important. But yeah, so I'm gonna show you how I chill out. And you guys can come with me. So let's go.
I love nature sometimes. It's like, I love to be made to feel super small and like insignificant. Like, we're just on a floating rock. Like, chill the fuck out. Genuinely.
Where are we? Pretty much. Bro, I am just screwing around at this point. Since I can't snowboard, might as well pull off this spot I always wanted to. coming to you loud and clear. Like the range, everyone's attention. Probably one of the best things I do to slow down and also just get some momentum going on my ideas is I try to have at least one day in the week after work or on a Sunday afternoon where I don't make any plans with anyone, and I just go get a coffee and kind of flesh out the ideas I have and plan content for the week and read or like just journal and enjoy some alone time. And I try to keep it pretty unstructured, but knowing that I have that little block of time at least once a week to just kind of work on my creative pursuits or whatever like I want to have time to do has always been nice. And I just like getting coffee anyway, so it's an easy, cheap ritual.
Feel me till everybody say they love you, but it's not love. And your suit is ox blood, and the girl you fucking hate you, and your friends faded off shots of what you ordered to forget about the game that you on top of. Your famous girlfriend ass keep getting thicker than a fly does. And when you forget her, that's when she pop up. And you gotta drop, but you ride around with your top up. Get three SUVs, but niggas dressed like refugees. And deal with the questions about all your excessive needs. And you do dinners at French Laundry in Napa Valley. Scallops and glasses of Dolce, that shit right up your alley. Yeah, you see a girl and you ask about her. Bitches smiling at you, it must be happy hour. They put the cloth across your lap soon as you sat down. It's feeling like you own every place you choose to be at now. Walking through airport security with your hat down.
That's all I have for today. Hope you enjoyed it. And take some time to slow down, chill the fuck out, relax. It's really not that deep, and everything is all gonna work out. So, hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know if you did, and I'll see you next week. Oh, please like and subscribe.